What happens in your code when you need to model units of measure such as meters or seconds or dots per inch or whatever? Do you use just numbers and then hope there are no bugs in your calculations? Or you really model units of measure? I will now write just a few lines of code and you start thinking what's wrong with my code or what's wrong with me writing code like that. Lucy is our trusted server in France. We read the width of something from Lucy. And another server, Michael, in the US, is telling us the breadth of that thing we are modeling. So this is some software in which we are working with dimensions of some things. And guess what? We want to know the area of whatever that is. That is where the troubles begin. Because what units are these? And here is the revelation. Our European server responds in meters as usual. And our US server responds in feet as usual. And so what is the area? What is the unit of measure of the area? Square meters? No. Square feet? No. It is garbage. This code is susceptible to bugs that stem from misunderstanding the units of measure that are used in different portions of code. Long time ago, programmers used to utilize the so-called Hungarian notation. I will tell you a few words about Hungarian notation later. It was a wonderful invention. A more practical and more valuable form was so-called application Hungarian notation, where you would actually specify the meaning of the variable, like meters width or feet breadth. Now look what happens. Multiplying meters width and feet breadth is obviously a bug, and there is no way that you would not notice a mistake. So we would need meters breadth as well to calculate the square meters area. But the times have changed. We are not in the early 2000s anymore. Let me show you a little namespace I have made. Metric. There I have a type called length. And then I can specify the unit of measure for each number I use. It would be 2 meters from this server and 3.1 feet from this server. Now, how come that I am multiplying width and breadth and getting area when one measure is meters again and the other is feet again? Let me show you the implementation. Length is just a record struct hiding a double value, which is always meters. It is normalizing all values to a common unit. And these are the extension property getters. Meters is just meters, but feet is doing the calculation and transforming the feet length into meters. That calculation, which I had to do at the place where I was using the measures, is now a part of the definition of a number that has a unit of measure. For example, the area is a very similar, very simple type, which always holds square meters inside, no matter what you multiply. Speaking of which, this is the calculation. This is how the area is calculated from two lengths using the asterisk operator. The length type knows it holds meters, and it can generate an area from square meters. That is why my original code works this time. The area is always going to be calculated right because the input variables are of the type length and the area is of the type area. There are no numbers anymore. Numbers could be visible when we print them on the console, for example. This is what we get from that calculation. Both variables are in meters, and the area is in square meters. There's no room left for bugs. Let me show you one more example, geolocation. WGS84 is one standard way to specify geographic locations. It is used by GPS, for example, by navigation. And I made the same mistake again by holding just two double values. Double doesn't have any unit of measure. Units here are degrees and not just any degrees. They are not the same. Even though both variables have the same unit of measure, they are not the same. They are not from the same range. And we need to model all of that in our software. Before I show you the solution to the degrees problem, let me tell you that story of Hungarian notation. It is a very nice historical lesson. Many years ago, a Hungarian programmer working at Xerox PARC noticed that the names of variables are missing an ingredient that would prevent programmers from misinterpreting those variables and in that way creating bugs. And so what he did was to inject the meaning at the beginning of the variable's name. For example, long pointer to wide string name. It's not just a name. It gives the entire structure of how that variable is encoded in memory. Some programmers started to complain that their programs are now reading like written in a foreign language, Hungarian perhaps. That makes sense. But you should know something about Hungarian language to understand how this works and how it came to be. By pure luck, I can help you with that. In Hungarian language, you form the sentence by putting the important thing first. If you asked Google Translate, these two sentences are the same. I'm buying a horse. But they are not the same. Vesek ajlovat means I'm buying the horse, I'm not stealing it. Ajlovat vesek means I'm buying a horse, not a donkey. And so, this programmer, whose name is actually Simon Ikaroy, came to an idea to put the important thing first in the variable name too. And so, the Hungarian notation came to be. We will now get back to the problem of geolocation and specifying the degrees, but before that, let me remind you that this channel is free thanks to the patrons. If you wish to help me maintain this channel, which is an expensive exercise, then please join the growing community on my Patreon page and become a sponsor. Thank you very much. Let's get back to code now, where I plan to implement location type so that there will never be a mistake when using it. For example, the latitude would hold the degrees value, but you would not create just any latitude. You would use a factory method in degrees which validates the value. If it is inside the valid range, only then you would create the latitude value. You can help your users like separating the north and south variants. They only differ in validation. The south variant also uses the negative degrees in the object it creates. The longitude would follow suit. It's almost identical, but with a different range of degrees. That is why these two types are separate. They cannot be assigned to each other. They are from different ranges. And there are also east and west factories, which can make your code easier to read if you know what you mean. The location variable in WGS84 standard would then use the strongly typed latitude and strongly typed longitude. There will never be a confusion about that. So, at the place where you want to use it, you would include geolocation namespace and then look. Just create the new location using north latitude 48 something degrees and east longitude 2.29 something degrees. Both are valid. That is actually the location of the Eiffel Tower in Paris. My code is perfectly readable and it is also perfectly safe from any mistakes from misunderstanding units of measure. Here you can even see it nicely printed out so you can read that as a human. Everything is safe in this code. That's all I wanted to tell you. Don't use just numbers if there are units of measure associated with them. Model the entire value with the unit of measure as a proper type. Modern languages, including C Sharp, will help you with that because they are very efficient with those small types. I used record structs in this example, which means that there is no memory allocation for that. The size of every object in my demo is just a double. There's nothing added to that, so it's very efficient and it's absolutely safe in all calculations.